Well, every show we do here at Jonglers is truly international. And tonight's no exception. Our final act comes all the way from North Carolina, USA. He's really talented, very, 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 extremely, hugely, wonderfully funny. Charlie Viracola.
Hello. Hello. Oh, right on. Yeah. I notice they have a lot of different holidays here in Great Britain. A lot of different holidays. Like, for instance, Guy Fawkes Night. Guy Fawkes Night. I've decided, though, never go boating on Guy Fawkes Night. No. Because if you get into some kind of accident and you have to shoot up a flare, people will just look up and go, that one's shitty. I like the holidays. One of my favorite is Halloween. You celebrate Halloween here, huh? That's a cool night. You get to dress up like somebody that you're not so that you can get as pissed as you want and make a big ass of yourself, right? Did you know that Jehovah's Witnesses don't celebrate Halloween? That's true. Jehovah's Witnesses don't celebrate Halloween, which I think is pretty weird. Of all nights for them not to celebrate, it'd be the night where it's okay to go to people's house and knock on the door. Last Christmas, I shot my own turkey. I did. A shotgun, I went out, blam, blam. The people in the supermarket were looking at me funny as hell. I think I bagged more than one bird. Get to go home and visit your relatives for the holidays. That can be a real drag, though. It doesn't matter how old I seem to get. My parents still treat me like I'm a little kid whenever I come home for Christmas. Do you know what I mean? First thing my mother said to me last year was, young man, now that you're home again, you're my little boy. So I stole $20 out of her purse. My grandmother still lives there. She's a nut. She just lays around on the couch all day and watches gladiators on television. Then she tries some of the moves out on me and my younger brother. My grandmother would fight unfair, though. She'd slap you with her hands and kick you with her feet. And if you didn't look out, she'd nail your butt with that little flap of skin under her arm. You know that wiggly grandma flap? You ever get hit with any of that stuff? It's like, whap, God, oh. She had it under both arms, too, so she could get that nunchuck action going on your end. And God forbid she'd stick her arm out the passenger car window. Whoa, should've be flying in the back seat. It's like, tie that down, put a long sleeve shirt on, do something. During Thanksgiving, she'd be passing the food around. It would drag through the mashed potatoes. Even the dog wouldn't eat that shit. She used to give us little warnings while we're eating. Did you ever hear this? You better clean your plate because there are starving children in India. You ever hear that? What'd you tell your parents when they told you that? Yeah, mail the shit to them. There you go. Box it up. I'm not eating it. In America, they have a TV commercial with this American star called Sally Struthers. Have you heard of her? She used to be on All in the Family. She was a really skinny, pretty little girl. Now that she's older, she's really big and fat, you know? And she does the commercial trying to get people to send money for the starving kids. I think she's intercepting this food and eating it herself. My grandmother's nuts, though. She has a glass eyeball. She does? And during Christmas, she puts one in that's got that snow shit in it. I just got back from Florida in the United States. I was down there. I went to a water theme park, a place called the Wet and Wild. It wasn't at all what I expected it to be. I didn't know it was a water theme park until I paid $100 to get into the damn place. Have you been to a water theme park? What a useless, useless thing. You pay like 50 or 60 American dollars to get in so that you can stand in line for hours on spiral staircases with what I hope is water dripping on your head from the anxious little bastards above you just to go down what I consider to be a 60 mile an hour high speed water enema. Have you been down? It's like, whoosh. It'll clear your butt out for sure. I had to put one in the parking lot of all Indian restaurants. Cool your ass down after that curry, huh? I don't like the water theme park, and I'll tell you why. Men, listen to me. If you're ever going to go down one of those big slides, before you get to the bottom, to the pool of water, cross your legs or cover up your canoonies, you know what I mean? Because it'll wreck the hell out of you. I hit that baby pool at 60 miles an hour, pow, ah! I would have drowned, but they swole up so big it was like pontoons. Keeping my ass afloat in this baby pool. See, I knew they would save me one day. You don't need to come to a comedy show to laugh, though, folks. Turn the television on and watch your local news. They have the weirdest damn things on there. They had a story on today. Some poor little kid in Canada apparently slid under the ice on a frozen lake and froze underwater. Now, the kid lived. He was fine. Nothing wrong with him. But they had footage of him dragging him out of the lake. Then at the end of the newscast, the newscaster said, little Timmy Jackson, who was frozen underwater for 30 minutes, beat the previous record held of 28 minutes. Like the kid was going for the damn record. What, are they going to interview him? He's going to go, well, I was under for 30 minutes, knew I had the record. Started to feel myself get a little retarded. I came right up. You ever been driving around in your car stoned? That's about it. That's all. I'm kidding. You ever been driving around in your car stoned and leaned down to adjust the radio and look back up and realized you've been looking down for like 5 minutes? That'll scare the shit out of you, huh? And you've made turns and everything. You're miles down the road. Who the hell was driving the car? I think the pot fairy flies in. I got it for you. We'll get your ass to Burger King. Let's go. People are putting jewelry on their face. I see a lot of them here in London. The body piercing, you know what I'm talking about? I saw a guy today, he had rings and hooks and pins and antennas hanging out of his cheeks and his nose. Looked like somebody hit him in the head with a fishing tackle box. Some kind of fishing accident gone bad right on this freak's head. What the hell? He had a spike in his tongue. Who did that the first time? Was he eating a club sandwich too fast? Didn't see that toothpick thing? Ow! Quick, hand me an earring! When's it gonna stop? One of these idiots gonna step on a nail at a construction site? Oh, shit! Hey, that looks cool. I had to ask him, too. I'm like, dude, why do you have all that stuff on your face? He goes like this, to shock people. I'm like, you wanna shock people? Why don't you get a job? You know what I mean? Listen, you guys have been a lot of fun. Thanks a lot.